This is WMBF News Today at 5.
Well, it has arrived, a massive blizzard pounding the Northeast. We're going to take you to the hardest hit areas straight ahead.
A state of the emergency is in place for some, and people are being warned to stay indoors. Our weather expert, Marla Branson, will be weighing in. But first, she's here with what's happening outside your door.
We're in for a little bit of a shock as you step outside. Temperatures have been dropping steadily overnight tonight, down to now 39 degrees in Myrtle Beach, 37 for Florence, and then notice west of I-95 in Darlington, 34 degrees. So a big change from where we were at this point yesterday. In fact, almost a 15 degree difference for some folks along the coast. Right now also, we have a little bit of a wind chill. It is quite gusty, and it will be gusty all day long. 29 is the number you need to dress for in Darlington. The wind chill is 31 in Florence and 32 in Myrtle Beach. So feeling awfully brisk out there. Now, the clouds are clearing out. Any of the rain that we had overnight is now also out of the way. And as these skies continue to clear, we're going to continue to see these numbers drop through 8 o'clock this morning before they finally start to rebound. I'll take you through the rest of your day coming up at 5:15.
Well, Marla, what a difference a few hundred miles makes. Our top story this morning, the blizzard hitting the Northeast, about 20 to 30 inches of snow predicted, with more possible in isolated spots in areas like Connecticut. The governor there ordering a travel ban beginning at 9 last night and said power outages there could top 100,000 in the state. The National Guard also standing by to help. 60-mile-per-hour winds also expected. As you can imagine, many were out getting last-minute supplies, preparing to be stuck at home for days. And in Massachusetts, the governor telling people there to hunker down and stay put. Up to 30 inches of snow, along with possible flooding and power outages, expected there as well. All non-essential traffic ordered off the roads by midnight. A state of emergency also declared. No word on how long it'll last there. And Rhode Island under a blizzard warning right now, a travel ban on roads, and indefinitely in place there. 16 accidents reported, but none were serious. City officials say they have at least 100 snowplows out on the roadways throughout this storm. People are being asked to stay inside their homes unless they hear otherwise.
And so far, the blizzard has canceled about 7,700 flights, according to FlightAware.com. To see if any of your travel plans are impacted, head over to WMBFNews.com. We have a link to MYR's website where you can check for any cancellations or delays. And folks, while you're there, check out this article. It tells you how Orbitz is helping anyone impacted from the blizzard. The company is offering 15% off hotel rooms for people stuck in the affected areas. They also have tips that you can use if your flight has been canceled.
And more details about what conditions must be met for it to be considered a blizzard. The National Weather Service issued a blizzard warning when there was the potential for whiteout conditions and, of course, high gusting winds. The wind speed must be at least 35 miles per hour and last for up to 3 hours. This blizzard is expected to last up to 36 hours with 60-mile-per-hour winds in some places. Now, we all know a lot of you have family and friends up north, so Marla's keeping an eye on what these folks are having to deal with this morning. And Marla, how long are we thinking this blizzard's going to last in that area?
They've got about another day of it. Things start to wind down as we head into the overnight tonight with a little bit of lingering snow into tomorrow. And, of course, more snow chances, just snow chances, thankfully no blizzard chances, as we head into the latter part of the week. Right now, the worst of it has now moved out of New York City. NYC kind of dodged a bullet. We're looking at Boston and the Cape really getting hit hardest now. And it's not just the snow. It's also high tide and some coastal flood advisories. In fact, some municipalities have already cut power to some locations, expecting high water, trying to prevent any fires or anything like that. Now, we do have still in orange here blizzard warnings in effect. The pink is going to be winter weather warnings and advisories. And so it's not over yet. I think Boston is going to be hit the hardest, but things are starting to improve as your day moves on, guys.
All right. Thank you, Marla. 5:04 is your time. Myrtle Beach and Florence are two of the worst cities in the U.S. when it comes to bed bugs. That's according to the annual Orkin bed bug report. Katrina Helmer joins us live from the Hampton Inn and Suites on Ocean Boulevard in Myrtle Beach. Katrina, this isn't the best news for the city, is it?
Not at all. This is the first time that we have ever ranked on this list. We rank 45 out of the top 50 worst cities in the U.S. for bed bugs. Now, I'm live at the Hampton Inn and Suites, and I want to be very clear, they do not have bed bugs. But the general manager tells me that this is a serious issue, not only for our hotel industry, but for our tourism industry as well.
Everybody, I don't care if you're the cleanest hotel there is, and we take pride in being very, very clean. But if you are, there's still that chance that people will bring them in.
Tom Moore is the general manager of the Hampton Inn & Suites. He says as the Grand Strand gains in popularity, the hotel industry has seen an increase in bed bug activity over the past couple years. The Orkin list ranks the U.S. cities by the number of bed bug treatments Orkin performed from January to December 2014. Bed bugs are not limited to any level of cleanliness or income, so they can be found in any home or hotel. People often bring them inside on their clothes or in their luggage. Moore says being proactive and taking every precaution is the hotel's top priority. That's why the maintenance staff is highly trained to check daily for any bed bugs. They check everywhere, under the beds, on the bedskirts, along the baseboards, behind the headboards, nightstands, and pictures. And at the first warning sign of a bed bug, they take immediate action.
No matter how hard you try, people bring them in. I mean, they come from other places, a guest coming from a faraway place, coming back in, stopping somewhere else on the road, they could pick them up. So we have to be real, real cautious and look very deeply.
Now they check all the linens every single day for little red or brown spots. That's a clear sign that bed bugs have been here. And the service staff tells me that the all-white linens they use at the Hampton Inn and Suites is definitely a plus. They can spot them right away. Reporting live in Myrtle Beach, Katrina Helmer, WMBF News.
Katrina, thank you for that. 5:06 on this Tuesday. Right now, Horry County Police need your help in two armed robbery cases. The first happened Sunday night at 9 at the Scotchman convenience store on Lake Arrowhead Road. Investigators say two men came into that store and demanded money. Both were wearing ski masks to cover their face. No one was hurt in that robbery. However, about an hour later, investigators believe the same men shot and killed a clerk at the Sun House convenience store in the Conway area. Officers went to the store on Oak Street after an alarm was triggered. They arrived to find an employee dead. The county coroner tells us 30-year-old Tricia Stull died from her injuries at the scene. She was shot twice. A man is on the run after he points a gun at a woman as she opens up the front door of her home. Horry County Police say it happened after the victim heard a knock on the door Sunday on Terry Drive. The man was wearing a camouflage mask, forced his way into the home, and demanded money. Two shots were fired, but no one was hurt. If you know anything about this case, call the Horry County Police.
Well, today's school choice week continues with a rally at the State House in Columbia. Governor Nikki Haley and others will be attending this event. The week is to raise awareness about the options available for students and their education. The Coastal Leadership Academy in Myrtle Beach will be taking students, parents, and teachers to the rally. We plan to have a live report on the event coming up at 6 o'clock this morning. And plans to put iPads and other technology in the hands of your elementary students have been put on hold. That was the decision the Horry County School Board made last night. The chairman questioned funding for the project, saying there could be a need to hire technology specialists to repair damaged devices. Now they plan to take another look at statistics and how well students are responding to personalized digital learning before their next meeting.
South Carolina receiving almost $10 million for programs to help the homeless. The funds are coming from the federal government. The U.S. Housing and Urban Development Secretary says that money will go to some 66 different programs across the state that provide services for the homeless. All those programs will help people who are living on the streets to find them services to get them back on their feet and off the streets. Your help is needed also to feed families here in South Carolina. Harvest Hope, all part of a brand new initiative to provide 26.7 million meals every year across our 20-county service area. One goal will increase the meal delivery through emergency and mobile food pantries, along with senior and child feeding programs. If you'd like to help, it's easy. Simply drop a donation off at the Harvest Hope Food Bank. That's located on Highway 52 in Florence. Officials tell us they provide 375,000 meals through their program every month in the PD. They hope to double that amount through this new program.
If you're looking for a job, there's a hiring event we want to let you know about. Palmetto Goodwill in Florence is holding a Hire Me event tomorrow. It will be from 9 a.m. until 1 p.m. at the Job Link Center on Second Loop Road. The open positions are at Lowe's, Walmart, and Home Depot. Starting pay, $10 an hour. You're asked to dress professionally and no experience is required. Starting today, some of you can get your taxes filed for free. The United Way of Horry County and Volunteer Income Tax Assistance are offering the free service. It's for those who make $53,000 or less, have disabilities, the elderly, and speak limited English. You can stop by the Surfside Beach Library and the Craig Wall Building on the Coastal Carolina campus today. To see those times and other days and places those services will be offered, look for this story under the local tab on WMBFnews.com.
And plus, keep these safety tips in mind when you're filing those taxes this year. The South Carolina Department of Consumer Affairs has already gotten some 200 calls about IRS imposter schemes. Remember, the IRS will never call you about taxes without sending a bill through the mail first. Use a legitimate tax preparer who has a preparer tax identification number. That's something only the IRS can issue. And when you e-file, make sure you use antivirus software and make sure you're using a secure internet connection.
It's now been 70 years since the liberation of the Auschwitz concentration camp in Nazi-occupied Poland. Hundreds of survivors are expected at the camp today as the International Holocaust Remembrance Day takes place. 89-year-old survivor Leon Wintrob was 17 when he was deported to Auschwitz, where he was separated from his mother and sisters. He managed to escape 4 weeks after arriving at the camp.
In my case, personally, it was this impulsive, the few steps, because a few days later, this block number 10, the youngster block, was taken to the gas chamber and all have been killed. Suddenly, in this
Nazis killed more than a million people at the Auschwitz concentration camp until the Soviet Army liberated the camp.
Right now, you're taking a live look in Massachusetts as that massive blizzard hits the Northeast, this area getting hit worse than any other. But you're going to hear more about how people in several states are bracing for the impact.